biotechnology and its application. What else we have studied in the last class? Applications in a different fields. What are those? What are the different fields? Tell. Ellie, take it more. What are the different fields? Biotechnology is used in what? Modification of microbes, fungi, plants and animals in a different fields like diagnostic, afterwards genetically modified crops, processes of food, bioinformatics, etc. Right? And in last class we have discussed about the biotechnology in agriculture. What are the different applications in agriculture of biotechnology? Agro-based agriculture. One. Next one is organic agriculture. Third one is genetically engineered crop-based agriculture. Now you tell me about the what? Genetically modified plants. What are the general characters of genetically modified plants? Hello, Kumba. Dhanagar. It is. It helps to tolerance the abiotic stresses. First one is it helps to tolerancing the abiotic stresses like what? Temperature, pH, or drought. Drought to the near the scarcity. That is the first thing. Second thing is it is going to reduce the use of pesticides. It is going to reduce the use of pesticides. Third one is it is going to decrease the post harvesting losses. Post-harvesting losses. And last one is biotechnology or genetically modified plants are going to increase the what we are going to call that as a nutritional value. Nutritional value is again in vitamin A now increase by using the biotechnology. Okay, in today's class we are going to discuss the next thing, that is what? Bt cotton. Bt cotton. And this is very important thing because so many times they are asked, write a note on Bt cotton. Write a note on Bt cotton. Bt cotton is the sense, what is meant by the long form of Bt? This is Bacillus thuringiensis. This is what we are going to call that one as a Bacillus thuringiensis. It is a strain of bacteria. It is one of the strain of bacteria. And this Bacillus thuringiensis, this Bacillus thuringiensis, what is going to happen? This is going to produce a protein. It's going to produce a protein. This Bacillus thuringiensis is going to produce a protein, and that protein kills the insect. This protein kills the insects. In antithele, the Bacillus thuringiensis, it is going to produce a certain kind of protein, and that certain that protein is going to kill the insect. Insect in a row, and insect in a row, and insect in a row. Now, what else you are going to remember regarding the Bt cotton? What are the processes and how it is going to kill the insect? Okay, that is important thing we are going to study. First thing we are going to remember, Bacillus thuringiensis, it is the strain which is going to produce the protein and that kills some insect. Right? Insect tandra yena, you all are studied about the phylum. Invertebrates of phylum ayam kundra lo. Stand up. Invertebrates of phylum ayam kundra yena. Last year. Phylums. Name the phylums. Nero. Nesra yena. Nena phylum kundra alam. Invertebrates of phylum chalakalathe last year. What else you have studied last year in invertebrates? Phylum. Man, you hangi neat amat computer degree hangi kuri avaro. Na kya avaro? Yeh ne intan tari kalla hai rana. Mante hai rana. Porifera. 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 Tinopora. Next. Porifera. First one is not. Porifera, Selenitrata, Tinophora. That is Ascalbumin. Anantara? Platyhelminthes, Ascalbumin, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. Hemichorid. Hemichorid are the phylum. Understood? So, these many phylums you have studied last time. Phylums are you have studied in the last year. Biological classification. Classification is the hierarchy. Hierarchy is the hierarchy. Species, genus, genes and genus, class, order, family, mundha, phylum, kingdom. Mela kathi theriyum hierarchy ku solla theriyala. So now here I am going to discuss something. Illena vera illa adhaani perfect bolta avaga. Illena enna na insects. Insects thandaga these insects come under which phylum? Arthropoda. Class insecta. Class insecta. Understood? So now, so in today's class we are going to discuss about the BT order, Bacillus thuringiensis. This Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a strain of bacteria which is going to produce the protein, and that protein is harmful for some insects. In a sense, it is going to kill the insects. And you all know about the pests. Pest, you know, here you know definition. What is the definition of pest? Pest. Any organism that can cause the damage for the plants or agriculture crops, those are called as a pest. And these pests including anything, here paathaanga organic means organisms. This is the including the organisms. So yena kekkuthaanga Bacillus thuringiensis, it is the strain of bacteria which is going to produce the protein. That protein gives the insect. If the insect is causing to the means insect is causing harmful to the what we are going to call it as a crop plants. Crop plants are harm maadukuntiddi adanna kill maadbekagiddi adu kill madakna ve enu madthiga biotechnology use madu artha idilla ellarige yaar na kelanodana. So this is the Bacillus thuringiensis. It is a strain of a bacteria which is going to produce the protein and that gives the insect. What are those insects atandaga? Here they are given what we are going to call it as a some orders. Illi na class nodidu insect andre yavada insecta order. Okay, now we are going to go for some examples. Order lepidopterans barbarinella. Lepidopterans second one is coleopterans third one is dipterans. In the sense, these are the different orders. Okay, ee lepidopterans la em vartavu tobacco budworm and armyworm. Two important example. Two important to these are going to cause the damage for the crops. Here the leopard, lepidopterans are going to cause tobacco, budworm, and armyworm. Lepidopterans are going to beetles. What is mean beetles? You carry one of the most dangerous rhinoceros that you have. Avela beetles. Okay, those are also cause the damage to the crops. Two important to roots and the cuttings that you have. Barrier parts are very important. Understood? Next one is dipterans. Dipterans are called all flies and mosquitoes. Okay, flies and mosquitoes also. Those are what pests. So ये परंतु ना ये ला. These all are pests. They are going to damage the crops. Okay. Now we are discussing this under the BT cotton. BT cotton in the sense, long form of BT is Bacillus thuringiensis. This Bacillus thuringiensis is going to produce the protein that is going to kill the insect. Now, what are the different kinds of pests are there? Those are killed by the Bacillus thuringiensis protein. What are those? Lepidopterans are both, coleopterans are both, or dipterans are both. Now, here one question is going to arise. Bacillus thuringiensis is going to kill the insect, then why it is not kill Bacillus thuringiensis itself? Athro protein irthi aa This protein is present in a bacillus foraminensis, that is in inactive form. Adikatakki toxic coagula. Yadik toxic coagula? Bacillus foraminensis kata toxic coagula. That is in the form of inactive. Inactive form kata ta yena protoxin. Adik ena tekerjo nama? Inactive. Inactive form that is protoxin. Inactive form it name kya bolo? One last question. Name the inactive form of protein which is present in a bacillus thuringiensis, that is protoxin. PROTOXINS. Any word? NS. Protoxin. So first time what we are talking about is the first step. Let's look at the okay. Protoxin. So this is what first. Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a strain of bacteria which is going to produce the protein. This is the what we are going to call that as a protein, insecticidal protein. It is a insecticidal protein known now because it is going to kill the insect. Insecticidal protein and that kills the insect. Understood? And what are the different kinds of pests are there? Those are controlled by the Bacillus thuringiensis gene. The Bacillus thuringiensis is now gene extract madavoli. That is helpful for killing the insects. Not completely Bacillus thuringiensis. Till the Bacillus thuringiensis again the protein is ready. A protein produce a yaw and gene bekla a gene at extract one of them. Till the other. Understood? Complete Bacillus thuringiensis all. A gene at the marine path and daga we are going to introduce into the different kinds of a plants. And those plants are act as a what? Pest resistance plant. Understood? In Bacillus thuringiensis protein are to kill the insects, so we are going to call this one as a insecticidal protein. And this protein is not in the Bacillus thuringiensis because it is in inactive form, and that inactive form is called as a protoxin. That is called as a protoxin. Okay? In our steps, we will go to the next step. Protoxin. What is the inactive form in the Indian manner? Protoxin. This is inactive form. Okay, so it is not going to kill the insect. When this protoxin or this protein, it is inhaled by the insect. Inhaled by the insect, what we are going to call that? Ingest by the insect or a pest. This is inactive protoxin. Inactive protoxin is the insect ingest. That time, that inactive what protoxin is converted into active form. It is converted into the active form, and that is toxin. That is toxin. And these are in the form of crystals. These are in the form of crystals. Crystals are the same. It is a crystal form of protein. That is the inactive form of protoxin. When this protoxin is ingest by the insect, what I told you, ingest by the insect, that time it is converted into the active form. Active form like toxic I convert. And why it is going to convert into the active form here? What is going to happen in the insect gut? There is alkaline nature. Atwa alkaline form of the gut of the insect. Insect gut of the training. Last time you have studied, I think so, cockroach. Cockroach digestive system. First we label the gut, esophagus, stomach. So the part of the insect, that is one part, that is called as a gut. There you are going to find the alkaline nature. Alkaline is the pH attribute of the 7. pH attribute of 7. So what is going to happen in pH of a gut, or an alkaline pH of a gut, that is going to what? Solubilize these crystals. Solubilize these crystals. Understood? What is going to happen? When these crystalline form, inactive form of protoxin, enter into the insect gut, in insect gut there is an alkaline nature, and and that alkaline nature of pH is going to what? Dissolve the crystals and then convert it into the toxins. Understood? And afterwards, what is going to happen? Last step, these activated toxins. Can I do a
problem? No, I don't think so.
Can I do that? These activated toxins, what they are going to go for? They are binds with the surface of midgut epithelial cells. Midgut epithelial cells and create the pores. Take down next. Create the pores that cause the cell swelling. And lysis. Lysis at the time of the breakdown of cell swelling activity, and the cells are going to means a cell lysis and eventually cause the death of insect. Important thing what you are going to remember regarding the Pt cotton in the sense Bacillus thuringiensis, it is a strain of bacteria which is going to produce the protein. That protein is going to kill the insect. And the protein is named as insecticidal protein. Understood? Sentence for the problem. Insecticidal protein is in the form of inactive. Okay? That is in a crystalline form. And named as a protoxin. When this inactive form of protoxin is enters or a when the insect is going to ingest the inactive form of protoxin, that is converted into the toxic form due to the alkaline nature in the gut. This is very important. One last question here. Yeah, convert into toxin because alkaline form. In alkaline pH of a gut, these inactive crystals are dissolved and then they are going to goes and binds to the what? Binds with the surface of a midgut epithelial cell. Midgut like epithelial cells are the epithelial cells bind at the and due to the binding of these what toxic substances to the midgut of the epithelial cells, it going to cause the swelling and lysis of a cell and eventually what? The death of the insect. This is about what the process how the gene is going to cause the death of the insect. If write a note on Bt cotton on the path, it will be Bacillus thuringiensis is strain. It is going to produce the protein. That protein, it is an insecticidal protein. We used to give the examples, Leptopterans, Amelae, Coleopterans. Last one is Diplerans. Then next you are going to write, this is in inactive form, protoxin. So it is not going to cause any harm for the Bacillus thuringiensis, but once the insect is going to inject this inactive form of a protoxin, there what is going to happen in an insect gut is having the pH, it is near about the 7 in the sense alkaline form. There these crystals are going to dissolve and they are converted into a toxin, and these toxic substances are goes and bind to the surface midgut surface epithelial cells and cause the swelling of those epithelial cells and lysis of a cell. Eventually insect is to die. Lysis of the what I told you swelling is pH yet repeated alkaline acidic less than 7 basic more than 7 alkaline it is near about the 7. Okay, this many things you are going to remember when you are going to go for the competitive exam and write a note on another interval. In Mundinu and important points, I am going to go for the next point in the next class. In BT cotton, wow, how, sorry, how we are going to select the gene? If gene is another, if protein insect kill one of the protein in gene, that gene is to select. How we are going to isolate this gene from the bacillus thuringiensis? Kita tahu lah, so kita ada normal. Apa itu? Bacillus thuringiensis lagi, kita gene ni hang extract mana? On the basis of what we are going to select the gene. It is based upon which kind of pest is there and which kind of crop is there. Theater, yaavad enpadne ninge enna leptospirans eni. I told you about the coleopterans. I told you about the what? Dipterans. Based upon the pest, you are going to extract the type of gene. And the gene which is responsible for killing this insect, that is called as a cryp gene. Itro gorodana gene illa aa gene hesare kodarpa andaga, that is depend upon the means the name of that gene is cryp gene. And in your book they are mentioned three genes. What are those in the sense? Cry1ac, Cry1ac, and another one is Cry2ab. This gene, it is responsible for controlling the cotton bollworm. Cotton, what? Bollworm. Cotton bollworm. Control model gene is trainer. Cry1ac, Cry2ab. In one mass question, mass analysis. Important. Final exam. Cry1ac and Cry2ab. It is controlled by. It is controlled. Which? This one. Bollworm. Cotton bollworm. Control mana? Kya gene extract mana? Name of that gene is Cry1ac and Cry2ab. General gene name is what? Cry. Third dollar is what? Next one, what are they? Cry1ab. Cry1ab. It is going to control the corn borer. Corn borer. This is very important. Corn borer. These both are important for one mass question. Corn borer. Third dollar is what? Understood? So this is and this one. This is competitive exam. Kuda en paathanaga kelagade 1 2 3 and another gene inane common gene cry gene onde idu anantara ige nimge en madidara nimma NCERT book naga ondu cotton bollworm anta matta corn borer bekananta gene mention madidare. So competitive exam naga mattonde adare gene haaki nimge en paathana question kelabodu. Teacher, which one of the following gene is responsible for controlling the cotton bollworm? Cotton bollworm. Atho A, B, C, matho nadra korbodu. Kelagane en madabodu? Which of the above is correct? Athada A, B is correct or A, C is correct? Think maadi confusing maadi adu ond dodda question madabodu. Shortcut naga, which one of the following gene is responsible for controlling the corn borer? Antha keli you more photo none of the above kelidaga direct ga bandu go pore try one e. Igi easy anustide yavaga ಈಗ ನಾನು ಕಳಿಸಿದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ನಾಳೆ ಒಂದು ಸಿ ಜೆ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ನಾಳೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ನೀವು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂದಿಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ರಾಯ್ ಒನ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಕ್ರಾಯ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಯ್ ಒನ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಇವು ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕದಾವೋ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ ಈಸಿನೇ ಇದ್ದ ಬಟ್ ಆಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರೋದಿರಲ್ಲ ಆಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದು ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬರ್ತೀವಿ ಅದೇ ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರೀಬೋದು. So one last question ನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರು ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ನಾಗ ಈ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ನೈದೆ ಹೇಳೋದು ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದಾಗ ಬ್ಯಾಸಿಲಸ್ ಥುರಿಂಜಿಯೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಜೀನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟೆಡ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟೆಡ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾವುದು? ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ ಅಂತಂದಾಗಿನ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಾಟನ್ ಕಾಟನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಬರ್ತಾವೆ ನೀವು ಬಾಲೋ ಬರ್ತಾವೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ನಾವನ್ನ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್. ಇನ್ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ ದರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಸಿಲಸ್ ಥುರಿಂಜಿಯೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟಿಸೈಡಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ then inactive form, when it is going to inactive, active, and if it is going to active R number, how it is going to cause the death of the kidney. When it is going to active, that time the toxic substances are going to go and bind to the surface of medullary epithelial cell, that is very important. Either long sentence bargarthanama, which of the following it is the wrong sentence regarding the BT cotton which cause the death of the insect. Agni the level. It goes and binds to the surface of the medullary epithelial cell and cause swelling and lysis. In correct sentence aga e sentence na mai kondu kodirthano acha kadme badlavane maarku kodirthu. So this is very important if you are going to go for the NEET or a CET. Here concept is a concept clear one to the other. Even many questions you have already had to buy. Tell you about. So this is about the BT cotton. Either mainly write a note on BT cotton for BT or follow mass question you will do. Arthaita. For that you will So I'm going to stop here with this BT cotton. Next class we are going to start with the pest resistance plan. Pest resistance plan upon the Now first I tell you to inactive insertion. Inactive insertion nandro bani peranona lakshmana biotechnology principles and processes inactive insertional inactivation example ayo pati unnali beta galactosidase selectable markers athwa what we have called as a sites ayyanto a sites 1 athwa 2 irabeku alli selectable markers nanenni ampimycin tetracycline nanu helittu ಓಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಏನು ನಾವು ಕಲಿತ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಇದ್ರ ಏನು ಡೌಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೇಳ್ರಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನು